So we've seen how after we've trained a model, we can compare our test and our predicted data. But the first time we did it, when we looked at it, we just saw a list of values. And it's not really practical to visually look at all the results from our actual test data results, you know, the actual values predicted, versus the values predicted by our model and compare them row by row by row. Visually, it's just not a practical way to look at things. So what we'll typically do is we take advantage of the fact that we're programmers and we use some code to do calculations to get a sense of the overall accuracy of how effective our model is at making predictions. But it still comes down to comparing the predicted values and the actual values. But the difference is what we want to do is use some calculations to compare the two. One of the most common methods we'll use is something called mean squared error. So the mean squared error, if you actually look at the formula for it, is just the mean of the actual values minus the predicted values squared. Now, I could write some Python code. In fact, you learned enough in the introduction to Python course to write a loop that would go through all the actual values, go through all the predicted values, subtract one from the other, calculate the value squared, and perform this calculation. You could do that. But there's a better way. Luckily, there's a whole bunch of great libraries out there that will help you when you're doing data science. The scikit-learn library has all sorts of great functions for scientific calculations, including one called mean squared error. So all I really have to do is import the scikit-learn library. In particular, when you're doing these types of calculations, you'll probably want the metrics. And then I just say calculate the mean squared error of my actual results versus my predictive results. And now I can get a sense of my total accuracy of the model. And generally speaking, just from a data science perspective, a lower value is going to be better. Lower error is good. Now, sometimes there's a whole bunch of different numbers and metrics you can look at. Another one is the root mean of squared error, which is just the square root of mean squared error, which we just calculated. But scikit-learn doesn't have a method we can use to calculate it. So there's another library you're going to start exploring with and playing with when you do data science as well, which is NumPy. So what NumPy will do is NumPy has all sorts of functions designed for straight math calculations, and including one which calculates a square root. So if I have the mean squared error method in scikit-learn, and I have the ability to calculate a square root with NumPy, then I can put those together to get my root mean squared error. So these are the two libraries that are really going to help you when you're looking to evaluate the accuracy of your model. Different types of models you're going to learn as you explore data science are going to have different metrics that you evaluate to check the accuracy. But generally speaking, between NumPy and scikit-learn, you should always have some method out there that's going to help you perform those calculations. So NumPy for the basic mathematical calculations, and scikit-learn often has a lot of specific methods for predicting and measuring accuracy of your models. So now let's go take a look at that in some actual code.